Adyel here, and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing a chit-chat get ready with me for you guys just on this day-to-day look. It's not really a tutorial, I'm just going to be giving you guys updates on my life. I'm going to be telling you guys about a cool little like contest-ish thing that I'm going to be running, and I'm also going to be talking about body image and just inspiring you guys to feel confident today and every other day and spread positivity. And yeah, I just wanted to kind of do a random get ready with me just to chat with you guys and share my thoughts, just the things that have been going through my head. And yeah, so be sure to give this video a big thumbs up. Also, be sure to comment down below your thoughts on the video and subscribe to my channel to stick around. It is such a fun time around here. I promise you will not regret it. But without further ado, let's get started with this video. Okay guys, so I'm gonna start getting glam. If I have like a slow start to this morning, I do apologize because it is 9 a.m. and I didn't get much sleep and I'm super tired. So I'm gonna be trying to wake up with you guys. Today's get ready with me. I am going to be giving you guys some updates on your girl's life, and then I am also going to be talking about some real topics or a topic pretty much. And I don't think this is going to be part of my Girl Talk Get Ready With Me series, just because I'm going to be talking about a lot of updates and a lot of my personal experiences. And I'm also going to be giving advice, don't get me wrong, but I feel like this isn't like a dedicated specific Girl Talk Get Ready With Me, even though it is. We're talking girl talk, it's just not gonna be a part of that series. But yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and just carve out my brows so I can talk to you guys when I do my shadow, and I will be right back. Ignore like the tops and everything. I wanna like finish my brows off when I have the rest of my foundation on. So yeah, but anyways, let's just get started. Today I just wanna do a simple eye with a wings liner. So I'm not really gonna be doing a tutorial, but however, I am gonna be using my Makeup Geek shadows today. I thought I lost this Makeup Forever palette with all of them in it for the longest time. I was trying to find them, but I was digging through my makeup collection the other day and I finally found them. So I was so excited. So I'm gonna be using these colors today. I'm gonna be using creme brulee as my transition. But yeah, before I start updating you guys, actually, I wanted to let you guys know of some exciting news. So I am working on merch and a ton of different projects, but for merch specifically, like, I wasn't gonna tell you guys, but in order to ask for this, I thought I would probably have to specify why. So it is for merch. And I'm looking for artists, and I'm pretty much gonna be running a competition. A lot of you have submitted artwork to me in the past, whether it's on Twitter, whether it's via DM, Instagram. All is so appreciated, like the time that you guys take to make me certain edits, whether it's videos, pictures, like that means so much to me. But specifically, I'm gonna be running a contest for merch. I'll have more details coming soon, but if you're an artist and you want a chance to be featured on my merchandise, then please feel free to submit drawings of me or any kind of creative artwork that you would want to see on my merch, and I will be picking some winners. I don't know exactly how many yet. Hey, that also like depends on you guys. Like, I'm sure I'm gonna have such a hard time picking out that the harder time I have, the more winners I'll end up picking in the end. But yeah, I just figured like if I'm coming out with merch, I want it to be interactive and I want you guys to be super involved and like have a part in it, especially the first launch of merch. Like, I want it to really relate with you guys and I want you guys to really like it. So be sure to DM me files that I would be able to upload to merchandise. And yeah, I'll probably be talking about it further in upcoming videos and such. For sure, I just wanted to briefly like mention it in case anyone wanted to like start working on it. I'm sure I'll do like an official contest video or something like that. As for updates, I've been working on that and a lot of fun projects. Today is a sunny day in LA, which I'm super happy about. And it's supposed to rain again, which I'm not so happy about. I got sick for the second time this year already, just because my body is not used to LA's cold and the rain, and also I don't have like proper jackets and like outerwear, so I was recovering from being sick this week and I've been on my school grind. Midterms are coming up, but you guys already know the deal, how I feel about school like being a priority. So yeah, I still need to do my video about school. Okay, so I don't want to spend too much time blending because the wings liner is gonna be the focus and I'm just going to class today, so. But yeah, other than that, I've just kind of been trying to make plans and schedules to start posting more consistently again and get like a 2 to 3 times a week schedule. And I've just been trying to come up with video ideas and things like that and get things pushing and get things moving for 2019. Honestly, currently I'm a little bored in life right now. I feel like I need a little bit of excitement to start. That would definitely mean being more consistent on my channel again and having videos to look forward to filming and editing every single week. So yeah, I'm excited. But anyway, I don't think I have any more updates other than those. My whole like inspiration for doing this Get Ready With Me was to talk about body image and stuff like that. So I do want to get started talking about that, but I also want to make sure that my wings liner is snatched today, so I'm gonna go snatch this liner, pop on my lashes, and then we are going to get into a deep talk. Okay, so I just barely have my lashes on and I'm just gonna let them dry before I like mess with the band or anything, but we're gonna get started with the face now and talking about body image. So I think this is a very important message and topic to talk about on my channel, and I kind of just wanted to talk to you guys about my own personal struggle with body image. And we all have our insecurities and our struggles. I know a lot of you look up to me and sometimes assume that I'm perfect, which is far from the truth, and so that's why I wanted to talk about this and just be real, because I feel like people don't understand that YouTubers are human beings that have struggles and insecurities too, you know? I also wanted to talk about this because I actually have gained 20 pounds since moving to LA and in the past year. And honestly, for me, that is an extremely good thing. And I'll talk about like my story and my journey in a little bit. But another reason I was inspired to talk about it is because like I don't get too many comments. I'm pretty lucky, and by the way, I'm gonna use the Lancome foundation today. I don't get too many hate comments, but I mean 20 pounds is a significant difference, so I feel like I've gotten some like both negative, some positive comments on my weight gain. And I did want to talk about it in a video and just about body image in general. Actually, this is no longer a match. When I first used it the first time, it was, but since it's been so cold in LA, I don't really have my tan anymore. And this looks super orange. I'm just gonna mix a different foundation. This is the BH Cosmetics foundation. Kiara put me onto this one. I'm absolutely obsessed with it. Okay, that's a lot better. Okay, but anyway, and I've just found it kind of crazy. I mean, like, being on YouTube, I've always gotten like comments on my body and my appearance and my face and just like every single comment you could possibly get, because I put myself out there and I have a subscriber following. But I've just been really shocked to see how like openly people will not even criticize, like just point out people's weight gain or people's like appearance changes. And personally, I don't mind it because I've taken people recognizing as a compliment, and I'll get into why later in like my personal body image and like what I see. But I've just realized that a lot of people openly and freely comment on other people's bodies and what they look like, and I just thought that it was important to address it on my channel and let you know that you're all perfect no matter what anyone says, because we live in a world where people feel very entitled to express their opinions nowadays, and opinions can get to people. But I just want to let you guys know that it's all about how you feel about yourself and your own image, and it doesn't matter what anyone else thinks about it. So my personal body image story, I'm gonna try and speed this up because I don't really want to talk too much about like my own story, as I do want to give advice. But growing up, I have always been underweight my entire life. You guys have always asked me what is my workout routine, and I've never had one, and still to this day I don't have one, but actually I want to start having one, and I'll get into that a little bit later. I've always just had a super fast metabolism. My genes, no matter how much I ate, I could not gain weight. And also I was always eating dinner at home, and my mom always made like super balanced meals. But as a teenager, I absolutely hated it. I always knew that I was like a skinnier girl and that I was a little bit underweight, but I don't think I realized how much until I look at myself now and I look at myself then. We're also going to talk a little bit about depression. Last Christmas, not this past Christmas, but last Christmas, around that time, I was suffering with severe depression, and I've already talked about a lot of the reasons why. And I was in a very toxic, mentally abusive relationship, and when I had first moved to California by myself, I was extremely alone, and I felt alone as well. I was just dealing with so much in my life and so many changes, and I actually lost even more weight at that period. So when I say I've gained 20 pounds, I've gained a good 20 pounds since that period of my life. During that period of my life, I was not eating a balanced diet. Like, I really wasn't. It was not on purpose. I have never struggled with an eating disorder or anything like that. If anything, I've always just eaten so much and never gained weight. When I was in this deep, deep depression, like, honestly, like, the worst place I've been in my entire life, I wasn't thinking about eating. I remember being so depressed, and sorry if I'm a little like mellowed down. It's sad to like reflect on it and talk on it, but I know it'll help people, so that's why I'm doing it. I remember like being in my dark apartment, shades closed, sleeping excessively, and I would literally only get up to pee if I absolutely like had to pee my pants. And fun fact, like, I can hold my pee very well. Or to get a sip of water. And I remember that I had like a box of Cheez-Its by my bed that I would snack on like for my daily meal. And I wasn't even consciously, I wasn't even like thinking like, oh, I need to eat this and that, because I was just so depressed. And I look back on that time of my life, and it makes me extremely sad and emotional, because those who know me as a very happy, loving person. Like, I know myself as that person, and when I was at that lowest point, it was just super bad. But, and you guys know, the past 2018, I really pulled myself out, and leaving toxic situations and people really helped me. But back to body image, I feel like as teenage girls, especially in our generation and with social media, it is so easy to get caught up in comparing yourself and wanting like the perfect body that everyone says is perfect. Like, now you have to be slim, thick, or whatever the standard is to be considered beautiful or a baddie, and that is not the case at all. And in high school, I actually hated being so skinny. I remember I always wanted so badly to gain weight, and I tried so hard. I did not like my thigh gap whatsoever, which sounds like the dumbest thing in the world, because if you think about it, body image and like obsessing over it, it is dumb compared to life and what we have to worry about on a day-to-day basis. But I had like a super wide thigh gap, and I hated it, and I like overanalyzed it. And I feel like there's always something we criticize ourselves about. Like, now that I've gained weight, I want to go to the gym because I want to round out my hips a little bit more and I want to tone up. And it's like, we're never truly fully happy with ourselves, and I feel like that's the worst feeling in the world. And we don't always realize, like, we're so hard on ourselves and we hate so many different things about our body, and then there's so many other people that would wish to have our body type, and that goes for anyone. A lot of the times we don't realize because we're so stuck on being harsh on ourselves. Yeah, like, some people have maybe told me I've gained weight like in a condescending way or to make me feel bad, but they don't know the full story. They don't know that I was always underweight and depressed, and now I'm happy that it's happy weight. And I feel like with social media, everyone's so critical of each other. And that's why I wanted to make this video, just because I wanted to empower you guys to embrace yourselves and your body. And like, I know it sounds cliche, but it's so true. We have to live with ourselves the rest of our lives. We might as well simply just fall in love with the state that we're in. And I think it's great like to set goals for yourself and for your body, like whether it's you want to go to the gym or you want to eat right, or you want to tone up your legs, or you want to tone up your stomach, or this is not. Sometimes we get so wrapped up in having that summer body or having something so perfect, or it's like we'll obsess over one thing, like we want to gain weight, then oh wait, then I want to lose weight in this area and that area, and it's like it's just a toxic and unhealthy cycle that I feel like we should all strive to break free of. And I feel like we should all stop being so self-critical of other people's bodies, appearances, because we never know what other people are struggling with. I'm not even just saying YouTubers, like honestly, I could care less how many hate comments I get, like it just comes with the territory. I know that by now, and I have thick skin to the point where stuff like that doesn't really bother me. Then also, I have the same argument of why do people care, and like why are people pointing it out, and like, you don't know, maybe I was insecure about gaining weight. And why would you want to make someone feel bad about themselves, you know? Who knows what people's intentions are, like when they point out certain stuff. Even if you have good intentions, you need to realize people are very self-critical of themselves, and if you're gonna point something out about their body, they're gonna think about it and they're gonna pay attention to it a lot more. We all definitely need to learn to be way kinder to each other and to ourselves. And you have to remember, you only live once. So I get it, like everyone wants to have their dream body and stuff, but how many times are we each thinking about our own insecurities throughout our day and inside our own bubble of, oh my god, like for example in high school, I'd be like, oh my god, my thigh gap looks so dumb, like I wonder if people notice it, like what if people look at it, like I don't want people to look at it, like things like that go through our head on a daily basis. And at the end of the day, why? Like, honestly, why? We are so self-critical on ourselves and even each other that it's truly just disgusting, honestly. And I wanted to talk about it to maybe motivate somebody through this video to work on the way you perceive yourself and the way that you talk to yourself and the way that you talk to others. And to also realize that life is too short to be stressing about all that kind of stuff all the time. And yeah, so I'm rushing a little right now, and I do apologize because I have to get to class. But that was my main purpose of this video, kind of just to inspire. If you guys do want me to talk about this topic in a Girl Talk Get Ready with Me further, talking about kind of like the steps to feel 100% confident. Like, I know I did Girl Talk Get Ready with Me on confidence already, but I would love to do one on like body confidence specifically, or just anything that you guys would love to see. I definitely wanted to talk to you guys about my little journey and also address my weight gain. For anyone that asked me how I gained weight, honestly, I truly believe that it's just happy weight. And of course, eating out a lot, as unhealthy as it is, it did contribute. No longer having like balanced meals and stuff, which I do want to change because that's just not healthy nutrition wise and that's also why I do want to work out, just to be healthier overall. Since I was in a rush, I forgot to add a very crucial part. Since moving to LA, my appetite has increased so much. I don't know what it is, whether it's the food is way better here, whether my metabolism is changing, or as I'm getting older. But growing up, my eyes would always be way bigger than my stomach, and my family and friends would be like, what the hell, Adyel, you took two bites, like, how are you full? And ever since moving here, even my family and like one of my best friends, Ryan, when he came to visit me, noticed, like, wow, you actually clear your plate now. So I eat 5 times more the portion size than I used to, so that also affects a lot, so I just thought I'd include that. And also, I'm 20 years old, and I wish I could just tell my 16-year-old self, like, stop stressing about gaining weight. Like, eventually you'll gain weight. And it's the same exact thing the other way around for losing weight. I just wish young girls, and especially my viewers, people would just stop obsessing over the little things and the small stuff like that, because I definitely wish I could go back and tell myself that eventually with time that I would get my goal body, and just to stop overthinking about it. So yeah, I just want you guys to realize we all come in different shapes, sizes, colors, and every single one of us is beautiful. I don't care if you think that's bullshit. I don't. We are all beautiful and we all have beauty, and we all just need to embrace it and embrace each other. And we need to embrace the fact that there's different body types out there. And you can't be looking at Instagram as a standard and Photoshop and all that kind of stuff. You can't feel down on yourself because of things that you see online, because we're truly all beautiful and our different body types are beautiful, and there's not one specific body type that's better than all the rest. But yeah, I am all ready now. I actually need to spray my face. I don't know where my setting spray is. Thank you guys so much for watching this Get Ready With Me. I hope you guys liked it. And I know I didn't go super deep into the topic, but I did just want to drop a little bit of daily inspiration and daily motivation for confidence in this Get Ready With Me. I'm definitely willing to go further into this topic in another video if you guys like this one. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I love you all so much, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye everyone.